No, this is the first time I've heard of it.
Like right now.
The really? Term microdosing?
Well, I'm not around anybody that's doing anything.
Yeah.
I mean,
it's a problem. I
guarantee you people at the poker table are microdosing while they're playing.
I believe it.
I guarantee you.
But it's kind of the poker table is kind of like you got amnesty.
Right.
Everybody's talking about shit they should never talk about in public.
Yeah.
Or in front of strangers
it's
and they
so
talk
much
about
fun,
it.
Isn't it? You don't play, huh? Never?
I used to a lot.
Oh.
And I would, but the thing is, like, playing poker at the time where everyone's really playing, that's... I'm asleep and then getting ready to wake up when you guys are finishing.
And,
your game.
Oh, and he's got an addictive personality because he.
No, not on gambling. I don't. Because I don't get. So like I am addicted to numbers. Don't get me wrong. Because like math is my all time favorite.
He's
thing,
a math
so.
Player.
That's so weird.
He's a math player.
I mean, it's the worst fucking subject. I hated math.
I hated math.
That was every single grade all the way through college. 110%
really?
Plus every
what?
Single time. And I didn't study a
dude,
single
dude, I can't
test.
Even do my...
Wow.
I can't
never
even,
study.
I'm out.
I can't even do my times tables now.
Yeah, I'm
bro,
out.
It was,
I'm out.
It was one of those things where people told me, like, you need to become a professional card player because you'll be able to count numbers.
Wow. Well, that would be blackjack then, right?
Yeah.
For him.
I became a tutor and all that stuff. But, like, it was the old... Because, like, numbers and strategy with mathematics stimulated my mind. That euphoric feeling from numbers. So... Yeah. But as far as like the concept of gambling was never addicted to me because it was just like, hey, let me go have a good time. You know, I win, I lose, like no fucking big deal.
Fuck.
I'm going to call him Rain Man.
Yeah, right?
364,000.
Yeah,
right?
I need my cheesy puffs.
Such a good movie.
No, that really is that I struggled so hard with math. To this day, if you ask me a multiplication question. I want to be able to like.
I'm terrible, but I can do roulette payoffs. Like what? It's so crazy, right?
I love roulette.
I sucked at math, but I can tell you what you're going to get paid out at roulette or craps all day long, no problem.
Wow, man, now isn't weird. The worst? Isn't baccarat like the worst? That you said gambling. Okay, so
like for a casino edge.
Well, hold on. Yeah. So like
no, poker, that's the worst.
Poker, you're playing the players. You are gambling to an extent, but it's more. There is more skill.
right.
So you have an opportunity, and
you're not playing against the
but
house.
The house games. What's the worst?
Roulette.
Roulette's the worst.
Roulette.
So can you just bet like red or black? You got a 50-50 shot.
Well, there's green. There's two zeros.
If it lands on a green,
so it's a little. It's not quite 50.
So you want to know crazy? You want something crazy? So out of the entirety of whatever amount of time, random times I've played, I've gambled. Period. I've bet green 10 times total, and I've won 8 out of 10 times.
That's incredible.
So what's up with Vegas Dave? Is he legit?
Oh man!
Come on, we're bringing it up.
No, I don't think he is.
Didn't he win the Royals thing? You know who Vegas Dave is?
Yeah. But I've always questioned it.
But you never know how many.
Not the other dude with the sunglasses.
No,
that's always talking shit.
Like, how many other teams did he bet on?
I'm Mike. This and that. Not that guy. I'm talking about Vegas Dave.
Yeah. So you know how many other teams did he bet on that year to win the World Series? You know what I mean? He could have been on 20 teams.
But he got $2.5 million.
Okay, great. But for all we know, just marketing-wise, he might have been on everybody.
And then he won the fight. The gal beat Ronda Rousey.
Yeah, Holly Holm.
Yeah, he got paid on that one. And then the Miesha Tate, he got paid on that one.
I had
one.
Both of those, too.
And then he got the Denver Broncos in the Super Bowl.
Right.
So he's a future bettor.
No, he's everything. But what I don't like about him is where I think it's like... fraudulent. I don't know if you'd use that word. He's a brilliant marketer. That I'll give him.
Sure.
But it's very misleading. Like he'll say, he'll post something like during baseball season, he'll say like, I'm 109-2 this year with my system plays for baseball. So if he says he's 109-2, that means to all of us, okay, so you bet on 111 games, you got 109 of them right, and you got two wrong, right?
Okay.
That's not the case. Where he sets himself free is his system plays. So his system will be like Monday, bet the Yankees. If they lose, Tuesday, bet the Yankees, but double the bet. If they lose, Wednesday, bet the Yankees and quadruple the bet. And then they win on Wednesday, he's 1-0 in his system plays. That's kind of misleading.
Oh,
right? Because if you shot the wad on Monday because you're paying him for picks, you might not even make it to Wednesday, right? Now, that would also be your fault because he does preach bankroll management and he does say, you know, pick a unit, you know, figure out what your bankroll is and bet one unit is basically 1% of your bankroll. So he'll say, you know, bet one unit, but people can't help themselves and, you know, they pay for the pick. So they're like, well, fuck it. If, you know, it's either it's going to win.
So
or
how did you discover that about it? How did you discover that he does bet once? No, double
because
down doesn't work.
I have multiple friends that paid him for picks.
And they all lost?
Who's that other dude?
Wait, hold on.
He wins. I mean, of course, there's days he wins.
Sure. But
it's very misleading. When he says
he's...
If he
wins for them, how much of it does he keep?
Nothing. You just pay him for the picks. So he'll charge. He'll do different packages. You can buy today's baseball package for $100, and I'm going to give you 8 games to bet on. Or you could buy the whole baseball season at the beginning of the year for $1,500. Or you could buy just what he calls whale plays, which are, you know, these are
giant number
plays. Go, you know, bet a lot more.
Yeah, 5-6 figure numbers.
Right. You know. So he's got these different packages. He's a marketing genius. There's no doubt about that.
What about Steve Stevens?
I don't know who that is.
Hi, I'm Steve Stevens. I'm the number one betting consultant in Vegas.
Oh, wow. I don't know him.
You know him?
No.
He's another guy.
He's
got a documentary. He's
never heard of him.
The guy I think is the best, and I'm probably people will say I'm biased.
Oh, your guy.
Is Bill Krakenberger.
I saw his documentary before I even knew.
On Showtime. And he was on Action.
When I saw him on your podcast,
yeah.
Is it Sports Junkies or Action Junkies?
So, no, neither. That one's Wisecracks.
Wisecracks?
That's his show. I'm just a co-host.
Oh, so you guys, if you're watching this, go check out that podcast, Wisecracks.
Yeah, and Bill's great because Bill is very transparent. Bill will tell you, like, he picks, like, 59%, 60%, which...
Is good.
Is extremely unbelievable. I think
good.
He says you could be profitable. I'm going to screw this up. Sorry, Bill. 52.9%.
I think that's about
you
right.
You can be profitable, something like that.
Like even
so he's very transparent with it. You know, he'll tell you, like, oh, I had a losing week for the first time in a while or whatever.
I saw that documentary, and it was funny because I bet, sports bet, but I'm not, like, I don't have a system. I'm not a professional. I'm a weekend warrior. This year I didn't do any, but then I saw the documentary. Then I saw him on your show.
Yeah.
No, I think I saw him at the football stadium first with you at the radio.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, wait, I know that dude. And then I said, wait, that's a guy that was, he was living in Queens Ridge at the time, blah, blah, blah. I showed the documentary.
Yeah,
he's really good. He sits at the casino with his little, his notepad.
Yeah, all day long. I mean, he puts the work in. He's got a whole staff.
He's got a laptop. He's like the sports, he's just going.
And he's got like numbers guys, like statisticians that like just look into every possible.
So he has a whole team.
Yeah, he has a whole team. I don't know how many are on the team, but, he doesn't really like to pick a side, what they call sides. You know, you pick New England or pick Dallas to win. He doesn't care about that.
He
likes
numbers.
The prop bets. So he likes, you know, most passing yards or most rushing yards or first,
So if you duplicated his system, you'd win.
If you bet with him consistently over the long haul, like over a year, you will absolutely win money. There's no that. Undebatable.
This was Vegas Steve.
No, with Bill Krakenberger.
Oh,
with the guy.
The guy that's on the podcast.
Yeah, I co-host his sports betting show.
Okay.
So that's why I say I'm probably biased, but I've seen it. I mean, I've got friends that, I mean, they win. I mean, he wins, you know, but again, it's, you know, he'll tell you it's 59%, you know, but you do that over time and you manage your bankroll, you're good. You know,
that's all he's done for 20 years.
At least that's like a realistic, like believable number. I got 59% winnings. Okay. That's
right. Huge, though.
Right. So when you see these guys that are like, not just Vegas Dave, they all do it. You know, I'm 104-9. Like, you're not. It's impossible. If that was the case, if it was that easy to
everybody
you'd get kicked out of the casinos.
Rich.
Well, Vegas Dave got kicked out of the casinos.
Yeah, they've all pretty much been kicked out. Yeah. They won't take the action. You know, like Bill, he can't bet at, I should know all these. I think he can't bet at William Hill. Sportsbooks anymore. He can't bet at any station's casinos.
Why?
They won't take his action because he's just got an edge. They know he's got an edge.
He's winning.
He showed me he's got an app that I think he had built that aggregates all of the lines at all of the sportsbooks. So you could literally see like DraftKings, FanDuel, Caesars, you know, Bellagio, whatever. And he'll show me. He'll say, look, I'm going to make a bet right here. And he'll only bet like $200, let's say, on something. And he'll tell me, as soon as I make this bet, right now it's -7, it's going to go down to like -6. And he moves the line because it's specifically him betting. It's not the dollar amount.
So
it's him betting.
They know in the casino.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I've watched him do it. And he's told me, like, watch, I'm going to make this bet right now and the line's going to move. Watch. And he does it and boom, it moves. And it moves across the board.
Because he's registered. They see his name.
They know that it's him. Right. Right.
Can he like go in under a secret name?
He could, but he doesn't. He doesn't.
No, because then you got to change your social security, all that stuff.
Well, yeah, and it's just, you know, it's
no,
a
like
I'm going to
get
it
on someone else's account.
Yeah.
Well, Dana White got kicked out of. He's
for blackjack.
He can't go to certain casinos either.
Yeah.
Why?
Because he just wins too much.
Kills him.
They don't want his action.
He's won so much money in blackjack, they won't let him.
Oddly, the only place, well, not the only, but I think like the place that he plays the most is Stations Casinos, which is owned by the Fertittas, which is his old business partners. But like, they'll take his action.
Red Rock is owned by them, right?
Yeah, Red Rock, yeah. Circa, we had Derek Stevens on Wisecracks. He owns Circa, and he owns the D. And I said, hypothetically, I said, he's friends with Dana. I said, so will you take Dana's action? He's like, Dana's welcome here anytime. He wants to place bets. Yeah, so.
Hey, guys, thanks for watching the channel. If you like what you saw today, find value in what you saw, please share with your friends and family.
And make sure you smash the like button, subscribe to this channel, and in the comment section below, let us know which topics you would like us to cover in the future.